continuing the discussion of the color sensor, we'll discuss here about the color sensor detecting light. The sensor itself actually reads values from 0 to 1024. These are the raw values that it reads. However, when programming, typically you read the scaled values, which will be in a 0 to 100 range. 0 represents dark, when the color sensor is reading very little light, and 100 represents the lighter colors when the sensor is detecting lots of light. This means that in between the two of them will be a continuous grayscale of different values from 0 to 100. On the dark end, this is when it's completely covered up, it's in a dark room, and actually very rarely you'll read values this low. Similarly, you won't get to 100 unless there's a flashlight or some other light source directly shining into the photoresistor. I sometimes think of the color sensor not so much like an eyeball, which are representing like a camera, but rather more like an eyeball looking through a tube that's sort of getting a sense of what the surface is, as you only get one value back representing what the sensor sees. Looking at the side here, when the sensor is far away from a surface, it's actually going to be a very large radius at the base of this cone that the sensor sees. And so you'll often want to keep your sensor very close to the surface in order to keep that distance small, the cone shape smaller, and get a better representation of what value it is. This comes into play, for instance, when doing line detection. If you're following a line, when you're outside the line, you might read a value on this light surface like 60. When you're completely over the line, you might read a value like 40. When you're exactly on the line, and the light sensor is directly above the edge of the line, again, you'll get an average of this circle, in which case you might read something like 50. This comes into play if you're trying to detect it, because 50 should be that threshold value that you use for detecting the line.